God to thee. I come before thee today to bring another video. Amen. Not of my own mind, but of the eternal Shekinah. Amen. And I ask that she bless my crystalline eye, heart, and throat chakra, but all my chakras, that I may speak not of my own mind, but of the eternal Shekinah. Amen. Amen. And I just say, one of my beloved precepts, which is Psalms 51 and 11, and it goes a little bit like this. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me thy joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with all thy free spirit. Lock unto glory. Only through the Shekinah, that is from the Father, shall we get overstanding. You know what I'm saying? So, with that being said, you know what I'm saying? We're going to say some of our ministries that we provide for the chosen children. You know what I'm saying? So, if you want to contact us, glory be unto thee. If you want to contact us, go to Upper Eons on Facebook. And then in the bottom of the video, in the description box, we got my brother Adolph email and my email. My brother Adolph email is dothaman@al.com. dothaman@al.com. That's my big brother Adolph. You know what I'm saying? Then you got my email, dearbeyisrael@gmail.com. Then we got the Bookbind Ministry. You need a Nag Hammadi, which is also called the book in the Bible, which is called the War of the Lord. The wards of the Lord. That's the Nag Hammadi. You need assistance, contact us. We got a food ministry named after my brother's Rudolph beloved mother, Chandra Johnson. You know what I'm saying? You know any women or children that may need assistance, contact us. You know what I'm saying? Then we got a video ministry by my brother Benaiah and my brother Chase. All this information is in the description box at the bottom of the video. If you don't see it in one video, go to the previous video. They have it in there. You know what I'm saying? We got the blog talk, Lord's Will, every Sunday at 11 a.m. And then after that, we got the PAL talk every Sunday at 12 p.m. The PAL talk is called the Sons of the L, numeral 2, all capital letters. Sons of the L, numeral 2, all capital letters. And that's at 12 p.m. The blog talk, Lord's Will, is at 11 a.m. But both of them, Lord's Will, that we may have those things, you know what I'm saying? So those are the ministries, you know what I'm saying, that we provide for the chosen children, you know what I'm saying? So, amen. Woo! Let's move on into the video that we may have overstanding of what the Divine Mother has given me this day, you know what I'm saying? So, the title of the video is, I Have Come Not for Peace, but the sword in war. I have come not for peace, but for the sword in war. You know what I'm saying? So, a lot of people don't, especially Gentiles, don't want to talk about what Christ's real purpose of returning for. You know what I'm saying? So that's what we're going to talk about today. So with that being said, look at your glory. Let's move on into the video that we may get overstanding. God is my All right. Now what we're going to do is, we're going to talk about a man, some of the glory that the Divine Mother has truly given unto me. You know what I'm saying? Amen. We got a picture on the screen. Well, I'm going to say this. You know, them Edomites, them Gentiles, the Archons, all of our enemies in the spiritual as well as the physical. They are literally terrified of us. It goes beyond any imagination you have, the terror that we bring to these wicked ones, the heathen, the stranger, and the Gentile, and definitely the wicked ones. We strike terror in them of what we are and what we gonna be again. We always were. We are just dormant. You know what I'm saying? Sleep and slumber for a little while. Now, before I even get into the video, you know what I'm saying? My man, look at the glory. The Divine Mother, look at the glory. She is on the scene. She on deck. And we must give her glory. You know what I'm saying? So at this present moment, amen, look at the glory. I must give a moment of quietness to give her glory, that I may commune with her from within. So let's give it a pause for a second, that I may give her glory, the Divine Metaneta. Look at the glory. Look at the glory. Well, she is truly worthy. And I truly thank her. Amen. It is an honor and my pleasure to do the work and the will of my Divine Metaneta, my mother. Truly, she is worthy. And like I told y'all before, I know y'all be like a deer. Why you don't talk about the Father? Like I said, I love my Father. But he has put the Divine Mother in charge. And that is where my foundation is established. Where my wisdom comes from. My intellect, my knowledge is given to me by her. In her alone, that my feet may walk on solid ground, on the path, the straight path that leads to eternity. Look at the glory. Only through her shall these great mysteries of old be revealed. The mystery of mystery. All right, amen. The Divine Mother truly She has given me more understanding. You know, back in the day when I first started, the Divine Mother blessed me to start doing videos. I had understanding from a lot of different things the Divine Mother has given me. And when I used to do the videos, you know, all the information that I had, I used to read this, read that, and study this and study that. And the Spirit said, okay, then you can do a video about that. So basically, I kind of somewhat, through her guidance, I was somewhat picking what I wanted to do for this information that the Divine Mother wanted me to bring out. She was allowing me to basically pick the videos I wanted. You know what I'm saying? That I bring out the information. You know what I'm saying? Because she knew we had dang near 6-7 more years to go. You know what I'm saying? So, when she gave me the understanding, she like, well, go ahead, son. Make your videos. You know what I'm saying? I'm with you. Bear with me. She said, I'm with you. Go on, do your work. Because in the beginning, I didn't know the mother, but she knew me. You know what I'm saying? I didn't know the mother, but she knew me. You know what I'm saying? So she let me do the videos, whatever I wanted to do, this, that, whatever. I get understanding. She's like, bring it on out. Bring it on out. But look at the glory. In my latter days, when she gave me clarity, she gave me discernment, she gave me divine wisdom, she gave me divine knowledge, she gave me divine intellect, and she gave me divine understanding, that I may see her mysteries, the lesser and the greater, that I was able to do her work, not drinking milk, but eating the meat and the bread. Oh, that I was not on pabum or milk anymore. She said, it is time. Now when I do videos, oh my glory, she is the one who guides me. She is the one who tell me what video to do and what one not to do. This one today is another one by her hand, and her hand alone was this information brought out in detail. You know what I'm saying? And I truly thank her. So let's move on in the video. Now on the screen, we got an angel. And I wanted to put a black angel because imagery is everything when you have understanding. Let me tell you something. These Edomites, all these wicked ones, these Gentiles, heathens, and strangers, and wicked ones, they are terrified of us. I understand why now when they said, I forgot the guy I read, but they said to the effect, paraphrase, never put an image out of a so-called black man in power, in strength, and in glory, in warrior mode. You know what I'm saying? Because all the so-called black people need is one image of that great, his great self, destroying the wicked one. And it'll give him motivation. You know what I'm saying? So, that's why it's so hard to find a black angel, a black man as an angel, a mighty angel, doing war, battle, and destruction. You know what I'm saying? They hide them images. I barely found this one. You know what I'm saying? But that's why they don't put no imagery of a black man or a black angel doing war and battle. But don't worry about it. Because trust me, they shall see it. You know what I'm saying? So let's move into the video. And remember, understanding that angel is Angel Michael. You know what I'm saying? Ready to do battle. You know what I'm saying? So she gave me more understanding this day of the dollar bill that represents the story of divine man She gave me more understanding, so we gonna get into it. It's the reason why she doing what she doing. Why? Angel Michael, or Christ, you know what I'm saying? Or divine man, or the God man. Her children are being prepared for war. Let me say that again. The God man, who is in flesh right now, is being prepared for war. Understanding. So let's get into the video and see what the Divine Mother has given me. Let's move on to the video, brothers and sisters, that we have understanding. All right. Now, we are in the day of decision. Matthew 24, 37. But as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man. The Son, the God-man, that day is at hand, and ye are being prepared. But as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man. The Son of Man is Christ, or like I told you, Marduk, or Michael, or Melchizedek, or any name you want to use, Horus, you know what I'm saying? But the Son of Man is sleeping flesh, you know what I'm saying? And he is about to be awakened. Now I'm going to show you how we are in the days of Noah. What the Divine Mother told me to say. In the days of Noah, it say in the Bible that they was drinking and marrying and sinning, you know. They make you think it was just that simple stuff they was doing, drinking and marrying and, you know, fornicating and stuff like that. And I thought about it. I was like, wait a minute now. Just don't destroy no whole civilization just because they were drinking some liquor, you know what I'm saying, marrying each other and having sex. You just don't destroy no whole civilization for something like that, you know what I'm saying? They had to do much more, you know what I'm saying? So when you get into the ancient texts of old, the pseudepigraphal books, the book of Adam and Eve, the book of Enoch, it tell you that the wicked gods, the fallen angels, have manipulated the DNA of everything on earth, or what the Edomites call today, GMO, genetically modified organisms. You know what I'm saying? They have modified the DNA. I'm just going to say DNA because I ain't going to talk about the DNA of God, man. But they have manipulated, because they can't manipulate the DEA. And when they can manipulate the DNA, you know what I'm saying, of these physical bodies and everything else on earth, they have changed the DNA of the trees, just like the wicked gods of old, because they are scientists. You know what I'm saying? The archons, the fallen angels, they're scientists. They know how to manipulate everything. You know what I'm saying? So they have manipulated, and they're the same spirits and entities in these Gentiles today. You know what I'm saying? Of old. They have manipulated the trees. They have manipulated the water. They have manipulated the air. They have manipulated the birds. And this is what they've done of old. They manipulated the trees, the air, the water, the animals, the people, and anything else you can manipulate. Hell, they manipulated the dang sun and the moon, you know what I'm saying, and the stars. So they manipulated everything, you know what I'm saying? And so are they doing today. They manipulated the trees, the grass, flowers, to food, to animals, to people, pigs, cloning, you know what I'm saying? Everything they have done in the days of old, they are doing now. So you are truly in the days of Noah. You know what I'm saying? And when all that was done, when there was so much crying and suffering on the earth, then came the flood. You know what I'm saying? Thus shall it be this day. Because they done manipulated everything. You know what I'm saying? Now they got AI ready to come on the scene. You know what I'm saying? So, let's move on to the video that we may get overstanding that we are in these last days. Okay. The Divine Mother gave me more overstanding of the dollar bill. You know what I'm saying? That's why I told you that the Divine Mother would give me overstanding what to bring out. Okay. On the front of the dollar bill, I told you about the one in the seal in the 50 notches around it that mean the Jubilee. You know what I'm saying? Okay. George Washington, we're just going to use that, what they done stole. The President of the United States, they say it's the first president, but we know it ain't. Because the first president was a melanated man. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, we're going to stay with what's on the screen. Why is the first president, or the, I'm not going to say the first president, but I'm saying, why is the president called the Commander-in-Chief? You know what I'm saying? Because like I told you, that dollar bill represents divine man himself, the God man. That's what that dollar bill, that whole dollar bill is talking about. And we're going to give you a standing this day on what we are saying. You know what I'm saying? Okay. So if you look at that dollar bill, you see the President of the United States, which is called the Commander-in-Chief. You know what I'm saying? Now on the right-hand side. And then if you look at the one with the green seal in the middle of it, you know what I'm saying? You will see a shield in the middle of it with a scale in the right angle with 13 stars in it, and you will see a key in his mouth. But if you look at the seal in the middle where the key at and where the right angle at and where the scale's at, if you look closely with your divine eye, you will see a man in the white inner circle of that green seal. You look at the white circle, inside the circle is a white shield. Look at it closely with your divine eye, and you will see a man face there asleep with a key in his mouth. That's what the Divine Mother gave me. I did not never see this before, but she gave me overstanding and showed me. Look at the scales. The scales is his eyes. The right angle is in position where his nose at. And the key is in his mouth. But the scale, the bottom part of the scales, those are his eyes that's closed. You know what I'm saying? He's asleep and he is in slumber. You know what I'm saying? Now, we're going to see why they call the president the Commander-in-Chief. Look on the right-hand side. Look on the right-hand side. It say Archangel Michael. On the left-hand side, it say the protector and commander of the army of gods. Look at that. It say of the army of gods. See that? Why did it say the commander of the armies of gods? See that? It said plural. Meaning that divine man himself, the God man, is a god. That's why I say gods, the commander of the army of gods, plural. Look at that. I didn't write that. I got off the internet. Let's go out to the bottom and say, who is the commander of the angels? In the English epic poem, Paradise Lost by John Milton, the Archangel Michael commands the army of angels loyal to God against the fallen angels of Satan. You know what I'm saying? So I just want to let you know that he was the commander of the army. And then you look at the President of the United States, he is what? The commander of the military. See what I'm saying? Now look at the bottom. Look at the bottom what I got. What the Divine Mother gave me. What it say? What that bottom say right under the picture in the room? It say, Archangel Michael, chief and commander of the heavenly hosts. See that? the armies. That's why Moses said when he was opening the Red Sea, he said, let the stand still and let the host of heaven do battle for us. You know what I'm saying? He talking about the heavenly army. You know what I'm saying? And at the bottom it say, about Archangel Michael, over all the nine ranks, the Lord appointed the holy Archangel Michael, the faithful servant of God, as chief commander. See that? Now you see why the president is called a commander-in-chief, because he emulates the true commander-in-chief, which is Michael. You know what I'm saying? Who is Christ? See what I'm saying? So that's why the president is called the commander-in-chief, because he represents the God man, Michael, or Christ, and the gods who are commanders and chiefs. You know what I'm saying? Because we are Christ is our big brother. So we are as he is. See what I'm saying? So let's get more understanding. Now we got the part of the commander-in-chief, why he is called commander-in-chief. Let's find out the face that's in slumber in the number one in the seal with the 49. When it gets to 49, that's 50, which is Jubilee. Let's look at the face in Jubilee. Jubilee means give you back your land, give you back your rulership, and give you back your possessions. But right now we in slumber, in sleep. See that face in that one? See that little man sleep? The scales of his eyes, the right angle of his nose, and the keys in his mouth. Let's get overstanding of what that is saying. Okay, now y'all forgive my drawings, you all saying. I had to draw it for the ones who cannot see what I am saying from the divine mother that has given this overstanding unto me. You know what I'm saying? Now look at the picture on the left. See the scales? Those are eyes. Inside the green shield that say the Department of the Treasury, which is the Treasury of Light. You know what I'm saying? Now, see at the bottom when it say 1789? The divine mother gave me this overstanding. 1789. An esoteric overstanding. The 1789 is this. 1 through 7 is divine man. 1 through 7 is divine man. Well, actually, it's physical man. I meant to say. 1 through 7 is physical man. Those are your 7 chakras. 1 through 7 is physical man. Your 7 chakras in your body. Your 7 seals. Your 7 candlesticks, your 7 churches, your 7 trumpets, your 7 stars. 1 through 7 is your chakras inside physical man's body. But when you get to 8, 9, and 10, that is the Keter, the B'nai, and the Chokhmah. When you get to 9, you don't go to 10, because when you get to 10, it means reset. That's why I got 1 through 7 is the physical man. 8, 9, and 10, when you get to 10, is reset, because 9 is completion. So you have completed the cycle of the physical reality and you are moving to number 10, which is reset. That's why the three pillars, 3 chakras on the left-hand side, 3 chakras on the right-hand side, and 4 chakras in the middle, which is 10. When you get to the 9th chakra, you are at perfection. Number 10, reset, transformation, new man. You know what I'm saying? Renewed. That's why 1 through 7 is the physical body. 8, 9, and 10 is divine man. What y'all call the B'nai, the Keter, and the Chokhmah, or the crown, or the pyramid. You know what I'm saying? Or what y'all call in church, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Is the mother. Those are the other 3, the 8, 9, and 10, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. But I'm going to tell you, it means something different than the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. We're going to give you overstanding this day of what that is saying. You know what I'm saying? Now, I wrote under his mouth. Look at the picture first. See on the left, it got the two scales. See the scales at the bottom? Those is eyes, that's shit. Then you got the right angle, which is his nose. And he got the key in his mouth. But he's asleep. He in slumber. See what I'm saying? See? Now look at my picture, what I drew. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You know I can't draw with a dang. But anyway, it say, awake to bring war and the sword. Now, at the bottom, I got Romans 11. What I got? I got a Romans. I can barely see it on the screen. I got a Romans 11 and 25. It talks about sleep. You know what I'm saying? And then I got Romans 11 and 8, which talk about, I'm going to read Romans 11 and 8 so you can get understanding. Romans 11 and 8. It say, I'm at a Romans 11 and 8. Romans 11 and 8. It say, accordingly, as it is written, God has given them the spirit of slumber, eyes that they should not see, and ears that they should not hear unto this day. See that? Even unto this day, we all sleep. We got the eyes of slumber, and we cannot hear the truth. You know what I'm saying? Well, we waking up now, but I'm just saying, that's what happened to the children of Israel. That's why when you go to Romans 13, what is it? Romans 11, 25, it say, Romans 11, 25, it say, for I would not, brethren, that ye should be ignorant, this Paul talking, of this mystery, lest ye should be wise in your own conceit, that blindness in part has happened to Israel, until the fullness of the Gentiles be complete. See that? That is what the $1 bill is all about, showing you that the blind man is asleep. It is now high time for him to wake up. But right now, on the dollar bill, on the left-hand side, you see that man in there asleep in the middle of that green cell? See the scales, his eyes, the right angle, his nose in red, and the key is in his mouth? And look at my drawing. I got the key in his mouth, the right angle is his nose, and the scales is his eyes that sleep. See what I'm saying? But if you go to Romans 13, 11, what it say? Romans 13, 11. And that knowing the time, that now it is high time to awake out of sleep. For now is our salvation nearer than when you first believe. See that? That's why I say divine man is getting ready. When he truly wake up, when this dollar is finished and over with, it is time for the reign of the Antichrist, and the divine man will be woken. The lion that is crouched down, the divine mother, the Kundalini, shall wake him up. It is high time to wake up, because the time of the Gentiles is come in. It say, Romans 13, 11, and that knowing that time, that now is high time to awake out of thy sleep, for now the salvation is nearer than when you first believe. See that? It's time for us to wake up. The keys are in our mouth. We already have the key. That's why Christ said everything is within us. We already have everything we need. You know what I'm saying? And it's high time for us to wake up. The 1 through 7 is your 7 chakras. The 8, 9, and 10. And 9 is completion. When you get to 10, it's called reset, because you go back to 1 again. So you're back on another realm. Reset, start over again, the new age, the new eon, the reset. That's why 10 is start all over again, because 9 is completion. You know what I'm saying? If you go to Matthew 10:34, what is Matthew 10:34? Matthew 10:34. Let's see what I got there. Oh yeah, it said, think not that I have come to send peace on the earth. I have come not to send peace, but the sword. So when divine man wake up, which is that Christ consciousness, wakes him up, he come to bring war. When he wake up, he coming to bring war upon the Gentiles, the heathen, the strangers, and the wicked ones. You know what I'm saying? Psalms 83. He is the hidden one. While we sleep, we are hidden. You know what I'm saying? Let's go to Psalms 83. Psalms 83 and 3. Let's just start it. It says Psalms 83. 1. A song of Psalms as Asaph. 2. It says, keep not thou silence, O God. Hold not thy peace and be not still, O God. For lo, thy enemies make a tumult, and they that hate thee, see that? They that hate thee, and I don't even use the word hate. I have understanding that we're not supposed to use hate. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to get a video about that hate too. You know what I'm saying? Those that hate, they hate us, but I don't hate them. Everything I tell y'all, the Gentiles and other nations, is not out of hate or racism. It's just facts and truth. That's all it is, facts and truth. I'm not talking out of racism. I'm telling you the truth and facts of what the scriptures and what the information and what the science say. Just cause y'all been deceived by the wicked ones, don't blame me, blame your forefathers. Now the scriptures say, our father has inherited lies. So when you were looking to fault somebody, fault your forefathers, Gentiles, Edomites. You know what I'm saying? Not me. And say, for lo, thy enemies make a tumult, and they that hate thee have lifted up their heads. 3. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people and consulted against thy hidden ones. See that man sleeping in that picture? He is the hidden one. He is asleep. So they have stolen his identity, his nationality, his land, his science, his people, his wisdom. They have stolen everything from us. You know what I'm saying? They have stolen everything from us, and we are asleep. 4. They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance. See that? They have stolen our identity, our names. They got fake so-called Jews in Israel. Everything has been stolen from us. They said, don't let the name of Israel be no more in remembrance. See that? We are the hidden ones, the so-called niggers, the black people, so-called black people. We are the hidden ones, the Jews who fell asleep, who had the slumber eyes, but now is about to wake up. That's what that is all about, that man being asleep on the $1 bill. That's on the front of the $1 bill. Divine man, sleep and slumber. You know what I'm saying? Let's move into the video that we may have overstanding. Okay, now, let's get more overstanding of that dollar bill on the back. Okay, now, that dollar bill says so much. Okay, you see the ones on four corners? Those ones on the four corners represents the four angels at the four corners of the earth. Don't the Bible tell you that? I tell the four angels at the four corners of the earth, I'm paraphrasing, do not harm the grass nor the trees until the righteous and the elect are sealed in their forehead. The four angels or the four elements or the four angles. The four angels or four angles. See that? See those four pyramids at the corner of the $1 bill? Four angels or four elements or the four angles at the corner of the $1 bill. The four angels or four angles. I told you an angle is the pyramid is divine man. You know what I'm saying? Now, the pyramid is divine man, period. But you see the eye on top is your Christ over self or your Christ consciousness. And it's separated from the pyramid. So that's the 13 levels at the bottom, like I told you, is the physical body. The light or the eye at the top is your Christ oversoul, your consciousness. So if the little eye at the top is a pyramid, then when it comes down, the whole thing is a pyramid. It represents the divine man, your physical body, and your Christ oversoul. It's right above you. That helps you, that the divine mother speaks to give the physical body overstanding. You know what I'm saying? So that's what the pyramid is on the left-hand side. That's divine nature. You know what I'm saying? But let's go to the right side, the eagle. The eagle is divine man too. But if you go to Ezekiel, like I did before, Ezekiel 18, 17, I think it's 17 and 18. And the word of the Lord came unto me saying, Son of man, put forth a riddle and speak a parable unto the house of Israel. See that? He said, I'm in Ezekiel 17. It say the parable of the two eagles. It say, and the word of the Lord came unto me, this is Ezekiel, saying, Son of man, put forth a riddle and speak a parable unto the house of Israel. See that? It was given to Israel, the true Israel, the so-called niggers. You know what I'm saying? 3, and say, thus says the Lord God, a great eagle with great wings, long wings full of feathers, which had diverse colors, came unto Lebanon and took the highest branch of the cedar tree. Exactly. You know what I'm saying? And it say, he chopped off the top of his young twigs and carried it into the land of traffic, which is Canaan. He set it in the city of merchants. You know what I'm saying? So that's what he did. He went to the land of Canaan with his people. Then it say, let me go on to the other part. Then it say 7. Ezekiel 17, 7. Then it said, there was also another great eagle with great wings and many feathers, and beheld this vine. See that? The vine is what I wanted to give to. When you talk about the good vine, the vine and the bad vine, you're talking about two different vines. That tree is the vineyard. That's what that tree is talking about. The tree is talking about the vineyard. You know what I'm saying? That's why I say Ezekiel number 17, verse 7. There was also another great eagle. That's talking about the good seed. Us, the niggers. The first one is the first eagle is the Gentiles, the Edomites, and the wicked ones, and the heathens and the strangers. The second in verse 7 is talking about Israel, the true Israel, the niggers. It said, there was also another great eagle with great wings and many feathers. And beheld, this vine did bend her roots towards him and shoot forth her branches towards him, that he might water it by the forest and her plantation. It was planted in good soil, but by great waters, that it might bring forth branches and that it might bear fruit, that it might be a goodly vine. See that? The trees is talking about a vineyard. Now, look at the two circles. The circle on the left represents divine man. The circle on the right represents physical man. You need to bring them to the middle column, where it say one, in God we trust, that one God. When you look at the pyramid, you say the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. In esoteric, is the Son and the daughter coming together. Really, it's Adam and Eve coming together. The pyramid is the feminine aspect. The eagle is the masculine aspect. You need to bring them together, Adam and Eve. Eve is the pyramid. Adam is the physical body or the eagle. You know what I'm saying? You bring them together to make one, to make God, divine man. That's what the two circles are. The two circles are the spheres. Didn't it say your soul is a circle? That's why they two circles around them. The eagle is the physical body. That's why they got divine man or the pyramid or the Merkaba above the eagle. Not on the eagle. It's above the eagle. You know what I'm saying? So the eagle is the physical man. The pyramid is divine man. You bring them together to make one in the middle column, which makes you God. You know what I'm saying? Now let me show you about the vine. Look around each circle. You see those flowers? They made them all pretty and stuff, but you couldn't understand what they were saying. Look around those flowers. See those vines? Didn't it say gonna let the bad vines grow with the good seed, the bad seed with the good seed? And it say at the end of us, we shall wake them up. I mean, separate them. Let me go to that. Let me go to that. Where is that at? Let me go to that. Let me go to that. Okay, it's in John 15. Let's go to John. John, the book of John, chapter 15. Okay, it say Jesus is the vine. Okay, John chapter 15, verse 1. It say, I am the true vine. See that? Christ is the vine. So the vines is around both of those circles. That's the wicked vine. We are the good seed. Eve and Adam. Eve is the pyramid, which is the divine man. Adam is the eagle, the physical body. You know what I'm saying? Those two circles must come together to make one, to make you God. That is the B'nai. The pyramid is the B'nai. The eagle is the chokeman. The keter is when they come together to make one, to make God. You know what I'm saying? I'm in John chapter 15, verse 1. It say, I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. 2, each branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh away, and every branch that beareth fruit, he purges it, that it may bring forth more fruit. You know what I'm saying? So purge means you take off this bad stuff and clean it up and make it produce good fruit. You know what I'm saying? Then it say, John chapter 15, verse 5. I am the vine. Ye are my branches. See that? The branches mean the vineyard or the vine. Israel is the vineyard. I am the vine. Ye are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me, ye cannot do, you can do nothing. See that? That's talking about the divine mother, though. I'm saying 6, check this out. John chapter 15, verse 6. If a man abideth not in me, he is cast forth as a branch and is withered. See that? That means he got to be purged off, purged the dross off. He got to be cut off. You know what I'm saying? He is cast forth as a branch as it withers. And men gather them and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. See that? Now see around both of those circles, you got grapevines. See the little circles on them? See the little circles on them, the little fruits, the little grapes? See what I'm saying? It's around both of them. That is the bad seed, the bad vine. That is the bad eagle. See that? It's preventing the divine man from coming together. You know what I'm saying? See that? That is the glory. The left side, the pyramid, that's one pillar. The right side, that's masculine. The left side is B'nai. That's one pillar. The right side is the eagle, physical man. That's chokeman. In the center pillar, when they come together, that's the keter. That's one. That make you God. That's why the lower ones, the ones at the bottom, got to come up to the ones at the top. You know what I'm saying? To make you divine man. You know what I'm saying? So moving the video to give you more understanding of what this is saying. So now we know that the vines around the two circles is the bad seed. And at the end, they're going to wither them up. At the end, men going to gather them and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. That's what happens to the bad seed. That's why I say leave them, let them grow together. Let them grow together. See what I'm saying? And at the end, we're going to separate them. At the end, they're going to separate that bad vine from around both of those spheres, those two souls. You know what I'm saying? That's why they made them all pretty, so you won't pay it no mind. They're the only vineyards or vines on the whole dollar. You know what I'm saying? And they put them around the two circles, the spheres, which is the divine man, masculine and feminine. And they put them around, they're all pretty. You'd be like, oh, that's so pretty how they drew that. But they're talking about the vineyard, the vines, the bad vines. You know what I'm saying? Let's move on in the video. You may get overstanding. Okay, now, like I said, the pyramid is an angle or an angle. See, on the left-hand side, it say left, bene, feminine. See the three circles? That's one pillar. On the right-hand side, right, masculine. On the left-hand side picture, it's chokmen. When you bring those here at the bottom, I got between the two pillars, I got angel or angle. It's the same thing, like I told you in my last video. And in the middle, you got four circles. One, two, three, four. Three and three is six. Four is 10. You know what I'm saying? At the top is the crown, the center, balance, God, man. You know what I'm saying? Adam Katman. See that? So when you bring the two together, they become one pillar. Those are the three pillars. You know what I'm saying? See at the bottom, I got three pillars. You know what I'm saying? So that's what I was telling y'all. If you take three circles on the left side and three circles on the right side, and the four in the middle, you can draw a pyramid around them to make a giant pyramid. That's why I told you the pyramid is divine man. You know what I'm saying? The angle or angel. See what I'm saying? Those are the three pillars. You know what I'm saying? It's a total of 10. That's why I told you when you get to 9, when you get to the 10th one, the 10th one is the crown. See the three levels? You got 3, 6, 9. You know what I'm saying? That's completion. When you get to the 10th one, see the 10th one up there by itself? That's the crown. That's divine man. That's starting all over again. Renewal. Restoration. Transformation. See that? That's why the Keter is number 10. You must become divine man once again. Now, okay. On the right-hand side, that's why I told you, when you become Adam Katman, you become divine man. You become a Mason, my son. Okay, check this out. Now, on the dollar bill, you see I got it on the right-hand side. I got it drew standing upright, straight, up on the side of it. Okay, I should have made that bigger so you can see it. Well, I'm going to still explain it, though. Okay. The dollar bill standing right side up, you see the little openings I made on the top left corner and the bottom right corner? A dollar bill standing up on the side is the letter L and it's the numeral 7. If you stand a dollar up on the side, it's the letter L and the numeral 7. That's why I told you the eagle represents 7, the physical body. The L represents God. That's the dollar bill up on his right side. Those are a right angle or L. L is God. 7 is your 7 chakras, the 7 churches, the 7 horns, the 7 stars, the 7 seals, the 7 wheels. See that? Now, in masonry, my son, we already know, like I read in the torch with Jordan Noble Drew Ali. You know what I'm saying? We already know that the first Masons were so-called black people. It was the God man. In my last video, I said God man. Then you got human. Well, human was first. Those are the Canaanites or the Hamites. Then you got God man, which is us, the so-called Negroes. You know what I'm saying? The children of Israel. And then you got mankind, which is the Gentiles, the Edomites. You know what I'm saying? So the dollar, like I said, standing right side up, is an L, which is God, and a 7, which is about your 7 chakras. And then I drew 2 circles in there, and I see the little flowers I grew around it. That's the vine. You know what I'm saying? That's the vine. You know what I'm saying? But the divine man, the first, if you know about the Moors, I told y'all are Moors. Every so-called Native American or the children of Israel is a Moor. You know what I'm saying? Trust me, they are Moors. I'm going to bring that out in my next video. I'm going to show you that every Indian is a Moor. On one of my other videos, I told y'all that George Washington said, when we take their right, their birthright of Moors, we can never let them know or give it back to them. I did a video about that. Okay, So the first message we knew it was so-called the black man. Now, the first masons is an L. That's why I say square yourself. The letter L. You know what I'm saying? That's a right angle or angel. You know what I'm saying? The right angle is 90 degrees. Okay. So, if the right angle is 90 degrees, which is L, which is God, or the letter L, that's 90 degrees of wisdom, 90 degrees of knowledge. You know what I'm saying? That's why the Mason says square yourself. That's talking about divine man standing upright, squared. Okay, now look at the right. Look at the right angle. That's the angle of the Masons, the white Masons or the Edomite Masons. Look at that angle. That angle is 33 degrees. That's not 90 degrees. How you gonna square yourself at 33 degrees? You can't. You can't square yourself at 33 degrees. That's only half. Not even half, because half is 60. So the Edomite is 33 degrees. So that means he's not even a real Mason. He don't even have the knowledge because he's 33 degrees. 33 degrees mean the physical man, the mankind. That's what 33 mean in the physical body, 33 vertebrae, which is the science of the white man. You know what I'm saying? That's 33 degrees. It's three types of men on the earth. You got God man, which is 90 degrees. You got human, which was 60 degrees. And you got mankind, which is 33 degrees. The Edomite was only given 33 degrees of knowledge. That's nothing. That is nothing. Period, that's nothing. The Hamites got more than that. They got 60 degrees. That's half, a little over half of 90. You know what I'm saying? And then you got 90 degrees, the God man. And I'm talking about the God man in the physical body. I'm not talking about God man as a God. Because when he become a God, he get 360 degrees of knowledge. That's four right angles. You know what I'm saying? They're making the God man. That's why I told you, when you look at the swastika, you're looking at four right angles. The God is four right angles. But God man is a 90 degree angle. That's God man in the physical body. The Edomites and a lot of the Gentiles, they are 33 degrees. They don't have nothing. That's no overstanding at all. That's fart. That ain't nothing. You know what I'm saying? So that's the difference between God man and the Edomites. The Edomites got 33 degrees of knowledge. That ain't poop. Now I got at the bottom, I got the angles. See at the bottom, the 90 degree angle. Then you got to see the 30 degree angle. I'm gonna show y'all. I'm gonna tell you what they are. But if you screenshot this on your phone and open it up with your fingers, then you would be able to see the angles. I should have just made a whole page of those angles. You know what I'm saying? At the bottom, you got 45 degrees. You know what I'm saying? And I think the Hamites have 45 degrees of knowledge. You know what I'm saying? The Edomites got 33 degrees of knowledge. And the God man got 90 degrees of knowledge. See, a lot of Masons don't know that. I'm giving y'all understanding that they don't know. You know what I'm saying? A lot of the Masons, they don't know that. You know what I'm saying? They don't know that 33 degrees of knowledge is nothing. They think they got it all and ain't got nothing. Divine man, when you square yourself, you can't even square yourself with 33 degrees. But look at the 90 degree angle. Stand up straight. Square yourself. That means stand up straight. Level yourself. Balance yourself. How can you balance yourself with 33 degrees? You can't. You need 90 degrees to make four right angles, which is like I told you, the swastika is divine man. Those three big dippers I showed you as the swastika. That is divine man. You have to square yourself. So see the difference that they have? That they're not telling you. See what I'm saying? Look at the glory. Okay, now let's go back to the pyramid. You see the pyramid right there? I told you those three pillars. on the left-hand side, I drew a line between each of the circles. One line on the feminine, one line on the masculine, and one line in the God, or Adam Cadman. Those are the three pillars. Let's go in the Bible to show you that. Let's go to 2 Chronicles. Let's go to 2 Chronicles. 2 Chronicles. If I'm correct, it's 15. 2 Chronicles. 2 Chronicles is chapter 3, verse 17. Now, this 2 Chronicles chapter 3 is talking about the construction of the temple in Jerusalem, but it's also talking about the construction of the temple of man, divine man. That's why I told you divine man is a pyramid. That is Sophia or Eve, the divine man, Adam Cadman in his divine aspect. You know what I'm saying? Then you got physical man, the eagle. You know what I'm saying? His seven chakras. Okay, I'm in 2 Chronicles chapter 3, verse 1. I'm going to read verse 1 just to read it to show you that it's Solomon constructing the temple. It says, then Solomon began to build the house of the Lord at Jerusalem in Mount Moriah, where the Lord appeared unto David, his father, in the place of David had prepared in the threshing floor of Ornan, the Jebusite, however you say that. But the point I wanted to get out about that, because I can get into something else with that, but I'm just going to say, it was just showing you the construction of the temple of God. It was talking about the divine nature of man. It was talking about the pyramid, the divine man, the man built without hammer or tool, your divine nature. Now let's go down to verse 17. Okay, well, it's the last verse. It say, 2 Chronicles chapter 3, verse 17. Listen to this, talking about the three pillars. It's only going to tell you two pillars, because those two pillars is one feminine and one masculine. They need to be brought together to make the God. It say, 2 Chronicles chapter 3, verse 17. It say, and he reared up the pillars. See that? He reared up the pillars. See, two pillars. Before the temple. One on the right hand and the other on the left hand. See that? And called the names of that on the right, Jachin. They made this backwards. They did this on purpose to throw you off. Jachin is B'nai. And the name of that on the left is Boaz. Boaz is on the right because Boaz is the sun. Jachin is the moon. Look that up yourself. Boaz is the sun. You know what I'm saying? God, man, is the sun. Boaz is the sun pillar. Jachin is the moon. That's feminine. So they turned that around on purpose to throw you off. You know what I'm saying? You got to understand what you read when you read this stuff. You know what I'm saying? So the right pillar is Boaz. That's the sun. Look that up. And then on the left-hand side of Jachin, that's the moon. That's feminine. So you bring those two pillars together in Solomon's temple, and it'll make you God. The physical temple, or the eagle on earth, that's divine man, or Adam and Eve divided. That's why they booked the physical temple on the earth. But he really was talking about the divine temple. He was telling you that man is divided. Now, if you go to your spine, you got your central cord in your spine, and then you got the two serpents that swirl around. The two serpents is the feminine and the masculine energy. Those are the three pillars in your spine. The center pillar is the center of your spine. The left side is the white serpent, and the black one is the right side. That's the black serpent. And they go around, curl around your spine to make you God, man, or Adam Cadman. Those are the three pillars. That's why one pillar is Jachin, which is B'nai, and Boaz is the right pillar, which is the Son, which is the divine man. You know what I'm saying? But if you look at it in the spiritual nature, you know what I'm saying? The Son, and I'm going to tell you this, if you look at it in the divine man aspect, it is turned around. Because Boaz is the Son, or star, which is divine man. The moon is a physical nature. You know what I'm saying? That's the physical body. That's the lesser light. The lesser light is physical man in a divine esoteric understanding. The moon is the lesser light. So that's the physical body. That's the body in darkness. The light is veiled. You know what I'm saying? So if you look at it in an esoteric understanding, it is right. But how many people know that? Not many. So Jachin is on the right hand side because it's veiled in darkness. The light entered the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. So in that aspect, Jachin is the moon because it's veiled in darkness or the flesh. Boaz is the Sun. You know what I'm saying? When he become divine man. The star, you know what I'm saying? So that's what that's talking about. So those are the three pillars. The two pillars that got to become Bohem and Jachin, they got to come to one to be Adam Katman. You know what I'm saying? So let's get more of a standing of what's going on. Okay, this is the glory. Now, on the front of the dollar bill, you got an owl on the right-hand corner of the upper one. You see that owl? That's on the dollar bill. If you look at the dollar bill from the front, on the right-hand corner, it's a one. At that one, inside that vine, I think that's a peace leaf. Bear with me for a second. Okay. On the $1 bill in the right-hand corner, that's a peace leaf. That's a olive, a peace leaf. Okay, at the $1 bill on that little shape that's around the one, that's supposed to be the aurora around the one. In that little dip, you see a little eagle right by the leaf, the peace leaf. An owl. See that owl? That's why I got that picture. The Divine Mother gave me this. See that owl right there in the corner? See that owl? I'm going to tell you what the owl mean. That's why I told y'all. When divine man wake up, when divine man wake up, he is ready to do war. Now, on the eagle, I meant to tell y'all this. On the eagle, on the back of the dollar, in his one foot, he got peace. He got an olive branch. But in his other foot, he got the arrows. You know what the arrows mean? The arrows mean when he wake up, he gonna bring war. That's what America say. America say they can bring peace. They come to bring peace, which we know them Gentiles don't. That's what the olive branch is in his foot. Meaning America can bring peace. But the arrows also mean he can bring war. But it also means when the divine man wake up, he come to bring war. That's why Christ say, when I come back or when I wake up, the Christ consciousness wake you up, I'm going to bring war. That's what the owl represents. The owl represents war. And I know you're like, wait a minute, dear. How the hell do the owl represent war? I'm going to read on the right-hand side what that owl represents. The owl is Sophia. Wisdom. That's the word. If you remember the movie The Clash of the Titans, when I forgot the guy's name. The Clash of the Titans, when the guy was being helped in the little metal owl came and helped him out the whole time. That's the same owl. That owl told him what to do, where to go, how to do it. That owl represents wisdom. Now let's read what that owl said. Like I said, you can screenshot these right here. You can screenshot them and read it for yourself. that Al, let's read what it say. It say, according to Wikipedia, the inscription is an abbreviation which may be translated as of the Athenians, the Athenas or the Athenians. In daily use, the Athena, so it's talking about the goddess Athena. Remember the Greeks called her Athena, but Athena is Isis. Athena is Esther. Athena is Esther. Athena is Isis. Athena is Sechet. Athena is what's the other name? What is her name? I forgot her dang name. But it's all that's what it's about. It represents the goddess Athena, Esther, Hathor. That's what I'm trying to think of. Hathor. That's what the owl represents. It represents Athena, which is Sophia. You know what I'm saying? Which is the goddess of wisdom. You know what I'm saying? That's why they got the owl on the dollar bill hidden. Because wisdom is hidden for most people. That owl represents Sophia. And it's on the dollar hidden. And you have to find it. That's why they got a crown around that dollar. The crown is wisdom. The owl. That's on the dollar bill. Now let's find out what the owl really is. And what the owl gonna do once the divine man wake up. Now I'm only giving y'all part of this information because the divine mother told me to. You know what I'm saying? Okay. I was explaining to y'all before that Urtza is Nibiru. See that? See that owl? That owl is a battleship. See that owl with the rays coming out of his eyes and the rays coming out of his stomach? It's called Urtza. Urtza is Jupiter. I was explaining to y'all in my last video that Jupiter is Nibiru. So Urtza is Jupiter. See it in parentheses? So that's telling you Urtza. Whenever I say Urtza, U-R-Z-A, that's talking about Nibiru. They try to hide it so you wouldn't know it's Nibiru. But I'm showing you now. Nibiru, the owl ships gonna come off of Nibiru. The owl ships. That's why the owl is on the dollar bill. But why my nose keep running? Hey, bear with me for a second. Hey. Okay, now the owl ships, they was here before on Earth. They the Sophia ships, the owl people, you know what I'm saying? Well, the owl ships, bear with me. The owl ships, they carry the eagle people in war and in battle. I'm going to bring that out in my next video, Lord's will. I'm going to show you that the owl ships come off Nibiru or Urtza, which is Jupiter. I told you Jupiter is Marduk and Marduk is Nibiru. When you say Marduk, you're talking about Nibiru. It say Marduk's real name is Nibiru. So Nibiru, I showed you in my last video that Nibiru is Jupiter. So Jupiter is Urtza, which is Nibiru. And the owl ships come off Nibiru. I'm going to show you that in one of my next videos. One of them, whichever the one the Divine Mother blessed me to do it with. Okay, let's read about the owl ships. Let's read about the owl ships. You know what I'm saying? These owl ships going to come back out. These owl ships going to come back out, come back to Earth. Like I told y'all before, I was telling y'all before, the whole Earth is surrounded. The whole Earth is surrounded with ships. They in the third dimension. They in the fourth dimension. And they're in the fifth dimension, they're in the sixth dimension, and they're in the seventh, eighth, and ninth dimension. All these ships. So whenever, like the wicked ships, they see the ships, they be like, oh, we got to set our weapons for this to take care of these ships. But they can't see or detect the ships in the fifth dimension, the sixth dimension, the seventh dimension. The Nibiru right now is in the fifth dimension, but you can still see it. The effects on the Nibiru is so strong, it can't come in the third dimension, to keep it real. You know what I'm saying? So let's read about the owl ships. Okay. See, now you see why the owl is on the dollar bill in hiding. Because the owl ships is what the ship, they're going to come off the bill. Let's read about that. The owl ships. It say, owl ships of Urtza. See that? the isle ships of Urtza. Urtza is Nibiru. That's why I put that up there. Nibiru is Urtza. Urtza is Jupiter. Jupiter is Marduk. Marduk is Nibiru. See that? I showed y'all that in my last two videos. See what I'm saying? Okay, it's are interdimensional starships. See that? Are interdimensional starships. See that? I told you we are interdimensional beings. There are multiple galaxies, multiple universes. So we are interdimensional beings. Because Nibiru is interdimensional. It go in all dimensions and universes. You know what I'm saying? It say our ships of Urtza, Urtza is Nibiru, are interdimensional starships that were used by the Eagle Warriors. See that? The Eagle Warriors are on the owl ships. That were used by the Eagle Warriors to travel across Shekinah. The owl ships were created by the Great Eagle Race. See that? The Eagle Race is divine man. They the ones created us, created the owl ships, which is Sophia, wisdom. It say, the owl ships were created by the Great Eagle Race of Urtza. See that? They was created on Nibiru. See that? Created by the Great Eagle Race of Urtza. Urtza or Nibiru. And fashioned on the owl god Unkaku. Now I'm going to get some more understanding about that, but not right now. On the owl god Unka, who could use the forces of darkness to see those that dwelt in the shadows. So what it's talking about, they had the power of the magic to control the darkness and the light. That's why I told you, you must master the darkness and the light. The darkness is the physical world. You know what I'm saying? You must master that in all respects. You know what I'm saying? But we're going to do that when we get, that's why the Bible said, I will teach you the secrets of the darkness. You know what I'm saying? Because you got to master that. You know what I'm saying? So that's what this do. The owl god Unka, who could use the forces of darkness, see that? To see those that dwell in the shadow. See that? So don't talk about the archons, the Valkons, or the Valons that hide in the darkness, the shadows. It said, these space vessels traveled in pairs under the instruction of Urtza. See that? The owl ships traveled in pairs under the instruction of Nibiru or Urtza. That's why I told y'all Urtza is Jupiter or Nibiru. I did that in my last video, like I said. It say traveled in pairs under the instruction of Urtza or Nibiru and were used in the Great War of Shekinah. The Great War of Shekinah is the Sun-Moon War. The Sun-Moon War. It say, without the owl ships, the Eagle Warriors would not have been able to penetrate Kronos. Kronos is Saturn. You know what I'm saying? Or Amun. Saturn is Amun. Amun Ra. That's not around anymore. Because Saturn is veiled in darkness as well. You know what I'm saying? I said in my last video that Amun was the sun that we had now, but I was wrong. Amun is Kronos. Amun Ra. That was Sophia's sun. That's why Amun was called, that's why I told you Amun was feminine. Amun Ra. Ra is the masculine aspect. Amun is the physical aspect. I said in my previous video that Amun was the son of Sophia, meaning the son that she used. So Amun is feminine. Ra is masculine. That's why it was called Amun Ra, brought together, masculine and feminine. You know what I'm saying? Okay. It say, without the owl ships, the Eagle Warriors, which is the eagle on the dollar, we are the eagle, the good eagle, but that would not have been able to penetrate Kronos, which is Saturn, to my date they conquered it, and do battle with Valons, or the Archons, and Kellifers. Kellifers are the cyborgs in the black cube. The Orthok fire ray. emanating from the owl's eyes. That's the fire that comes from the owl's eyes that I showed y'all. And body, see that? Could blind the Valons and aid in the elimination of surprise attack. Okay? So that's what the eagle gonna do. You know what I'm saying? So all this coming from Nibiru. That's why they don't want to tell you about Nibiru. They try to hide Nibiru with chemtrails, making the weather bad, controlling the weather so the sky can stay cloudy. That's why we were having bad weather all summer and coming into the spring. Because trying to block the UVA, the UVC, and the UVB rays, and also block Nibiru. You know what I'm saying? That's why you've been having crappy weather. You know what I'm saying? Now, let's read about the other shits. Let's read about the eagle warriors. That's why I told y'all the eagle, the second eagle is the good eagle. The first eagle is the bad eagle. Those are the Gentiles. That's why I told y'all all the Edomites, the eagle is their symbol. But the eagle or the phoenix is our symbol too, because they just stole it. Let's read. The eagle warriors. Warriors of the planet and dwarf star Urtza. See that? The eagle warriors are on Urtza or Nibiru too. See that? Everybody coming from Nibiru. That's why I told y'all Nibiru got hundreds of thousands of ships on it. You know what I'm saying? And they know that. That's why they don't want to tell you nothing about Nibiru. They act like they don't know about Nibiru. Them Edomites know about Nibiru. They know a lot of stuff about it. They act like they don't know, but they know. You know what I'm saying? It said eagle warriors, warriors of the planet and dwarf star Urtza. And I told y'all they called Planet X a dwarf star, which is Nibiru. You know what I'm saying? Look what it said. Eagle warriors on Nibiru. Warriors of the planet and dwarf star Urtza. The eagle warriors fought the Kelphas and the Valons. So talking about the Archons and the Cyborgs. It say, when Sullis and Urtza clashed. Sullis is our son. And Urtza clash. That's when Urtza was clashing. Wait a minute. Yeah, Urtza was clashing with our son to keep our son from being destroyed. You know what I'm saying? Hold up. Let me make sure. When Sullis and Urtza clash at the time of the creation of Kronos. Okay, yeah. Exactly. Okay. So Sullis, let me make sure. Sullis. Bear with me. Okay, Sullis was the son that we got right now. Sullis is the son that replaced Kronos. You know what I'm saying? So that's when they clashed with Urtza, which is Nibiru. You know what I'm saying? To keep Kronos from being destroyed or turned into what it's in right now, which is Amun, which is Kronos, which is Saturn. He fought so that wouldn't happen, but it happened anyway because of a time to y'all about the rule. Okay, it say Urtza clash at the time of the creation of Kronos. See that? The eagle's general Banjai fought for Sophia in the great war of Shekinah. The eagle warriors are accompanied by the golden eagle god called Altar. Altar is Christ or Adam Cadman or Michael. Listen carefully what it says. It say, I'm gonna start again. It said Eagle Warriors, Warriors of the Planet and Dwarf Star Urza, talking about Nibiru. The Eagle Warriors fought the Kalfa and the Valons, that's the Archons in the Cyborgs, when Sullis, the sun we got now, and Urza clashed at the time of the creation of Kronos. See that? They made Kronos from Saturn, which is Amun. The Eagle's general, Bonjal, fought for Sophia. Bonjal is one of the three lion priests. Fought for Sophia in the Great War of Shekinah. The Eagle Warriors are accompanied by the Golden Eagle. See that? Christ is called the Golden Eagle. The Golden Eagle God called Altar. Altar is Christ. You know what I'm saying? I showed you that in my last video. An aspect of Manu. Manu is the creator source, Barbilo. That's why I say an aspect of Manu. Manu is Barbilo. I'm saying Manu because that's the creative source of the whole universe. So I'm saying Manu, that's why he's an aspect of Manu. Christ, remember Barbilo birthed Christ, the first son that was born, the first thing she created was Christ. Altar is a Altar, an aspect of Manu. Manu is Barbilo. You know what I'm saying? That's the feminine God, the creator God of all things. The Most High, the invisible creative God, gave Barbilo the power to run everything in creation. She was the first shadow. You know what I'm saying? Aspect of Manu, who acts against Naga. Naga is Yaldabaoth. When he witnessed the capture of the moon and the movement of Amun. See that? They move Amun or Kronos out the way. That's why planet Saturn is where it's sitting at now. That's the black sun. Just before the war of Shekinah, the Eagle Warriors carried two small staffs, lightning rod. That's what Yaldabaoth stole, one of the lightning rods, the lightning bolts of Zeus. Made of metals forged on Urza on Nibiru. And they used these against the Kalfa and Valons. See how they use against the Archons and the Cyborgs. Their body armor is also made of this same alien metal. You know what I'm saying? As these rods and can conjure the electromagnetic field that takes the auroric form of the Eagle God. So basically what they're saying is, with this stuff, they put that Merkaba around them, and they like the Phoenix, and they do battle. You know what I'm saying? So that's all I'm gonna read about that. But I want to show you that the eagle on the dollar bill is the Eagle Warriors. You know what I'm saying? That divine eagle that it's gonna become. And the pyramid is the divine man. And the owl on the dollar is talking about the Owl Warriors on Nibiru. Nibiru is in hiding, just like the eagle. The owl or Nibiru or Jupiter is in hiding. Jupiter is Nibiru. Nibiru is in hiding. That's why the owl is in hiding, because they hide in the owl, so you don't know that Sophia, who is wisdom, is coming. You know what I'm saying? That's why Nibiru is called the mothership. The mothership is the mothership of Shekinah. Sophia, which is Nibiru. You know what I'm saying? This is some deep stuff and great understanding. You know what I'm saying? But I thank the Divine Mother for bringing out this understanding, that you may understand what these things are saying. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, I say peace be unto you, shalom, brothers and sisters. I thank y'all for coming out. I say peace and love to the angel of ether. I say peace and love to the angel of water. I say peace and love to the angel of fire. I say peace and love to the angel of earth, and I say peace and love to the angel of air. That's why I say I am everything that is natural, and everything that is natural is me. You know what I'm saying? This is only a little bit of the understanding that the Divine Mother has given me. It is more. The Divine Mother's will, we will bring it out. You know what I'm saying? So like I said, the divine man, when he wake up, he has been prepared for war. When the dollar bill is over with, and they go digital, that is the age of the Antichrist. And the barley shall be taken off the earth. And the other righteous put in places of protection. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, brothers and sisters, I thank y'all for coming out. You know what I'm saying? I thank y'all for watching the video. Hit the like button if you like what you hear. You know what I'm saying? It is a pleasure and an honor to do the work and the will of my divine mother. You know what I'm saying? Because truly she is worthy. So with that being said, brothers and sisters, I say peace be unto y'all. Brothers and sisters, peace be unto you. Shalom.